The French Navy's Charles de Gaulle aircraft carrier is the most powerful aircraft carrier in the world, outside of the mighty American supercarriers, of course. And that's despite the fact that she's a small carrier, about 40% smaller than the British Queen Elizabeth-class carriers. She's even smaller than the Russian Admiral Kuznetsov and the Chinese Shandong. But don't let her small size fool you, because Charles de Gaulle is a perfect example of it's not about the size, but what you can do with it. The primary advantage of the French carrier versus the others is that it uses catapult-assisted takeoff barrier-arrested recovery, also known as catabar. In fact, besides the American supercarriers, Charles de Gaulle is the only aircraft carrier in the world that's equipped with catapults. I know the Chinese Fujian carrier is also equipped with catapults. That said, she's still undergoing sea trials. But why is having catapults such a big deal? Aircraft carriers that don't have catapults rely on a ski jump ramp. The issue with using ramps is that they limit the takeoff weight of aircraft, which restricts the amount of fuel and munitions that they can carry. In contrast, catapults allow for launching much heavier and larger aircraft. This means that aircraft launched with catapults have more punch, as they have a longer range and can carry more weapons. But why aircraft launched from Charles de Gaulle experience more Gs compared to those launched from American supercarriers? How the breaking of a piece of the carrier's propeller resulted in a fiery scandal? Why French naval aviators operated from American supercarriers in the spring of 2018? And how the decision to give Charles de Gaulle unlimited range resulted in moving her island more forward on the flight deck is not what you think. Let's go back to the catapults, because they allow the French Navy to do something that almost no other Navy can do. First, Charles de Gaulle is the only non-American carrier that can launch early warning aircraft like the E-2C Hawkeye. The Hawkeye is equipped with radars capable of detecting targets as far as 300 nautical miles away. Without catapults, navies cannot launch these types of aircraft, because they're simply too heavy. This is why aircraft carriers equipped with ski ramps have to rely on helicopters for early warning. And of course, helicopter surveillance envelope is a fraction of the Hawkeye's. Another big advantage of having catapults is that it allows Charles de Gaulle to have interoperability with American supercarriers. This makes her the only aircraft carrier in the world that can operate all types of US Navy aircraft, including C-2 Greyhound, FA-18s, and E-2D Hawkeyes. Conversely, French aircraft can also operate from American supercarriers. Charles de Gaulle has a three-wire arresting system with two deck-edge elevators and two catapults. Each elevator can move two aircraft every 2 minutes. The carrier uses two American-built C-13 catapults, although these catapults are only 246 feet long, which is significantly shorter than the 310-foot-long catapults on American supercarriers. Each catapult can slingshot a 25-ton aircraft at 145 knots in under 2 seconds. But because the catapults are shorter, they need to accelerate the aircraft faster. This is why aircraft launched from American supercarriers experience anywhere between 3 to 4 Gs of acceleration, while aircraft launched from Charles de Gaulle experience 4 to 5 Gs. Charles de Gaulle can theoretically launch aircraft every 30 seconds, but in reality, the maximum sortie rate is 25 aircraft every 4 hours. Unlike American carriers, simultaneous catapulting and recovery is impossible on this French carrier, because both catapults extend into the runway. When it comes to landings, the Rafale pilot has just under 300 feet of runway to go from 120 knots of speed to a full stop. This usually takes about 1.5 seconds, during which the pilot experiences 4 Gs of deceleration. In total, Charles de Gaulle can carry up to 40 aircraft. 23 fixed-wing aircraft and 2 helicopters are stored in the hangar bay. The rest are carried on the flight deck. This aircraft with a pointy nose is a twin-engine Dassault Raffamarine multi-role fighter aircraft. Charles de Gaulle can carry as many as 36 Rafales, but normally she carries only 24 to 30 fighters. By the way, Rafale can be translated into English as gust of wind or burst of fire. Employing 36 fighter jets while leveraging early warning aircraft gives the French Navy the ability to create a mobile bubble of controlled sea, land, and airspace that's roughly 370 miles to 430 miles in diameter. And they can maintain that control as long as the ship's resources last. No one but the Americans have that kind of capability. The ship typically embarks two Hawkeyes, one AS-565 Panther Marine Intelligence Helicopter, and one Pedro. You may wonder who Pedro is. Pedro is a call sign for an AS-365F Dauphin helicopter, which has a very unique mission. During flight operations, there's always a helicopter in the air, located about 340 feet to the port side of the carrier. In case there is a mishap and a pilot ejects, having a helicopter already in the air will allow the rescue of the pilot within 3 minutes. This greatly increases the pilot's chances of survival. Now, obviously, during a mishap that requires ejection, the aircraft itself is unlikely to survive. But regardless, Charles de Gaulle has a 24/7 aircraft repair shop, which has more than a million spare parts in inventory. There are also two test benches for the aircraft engines. Why is this important? Because it allows the Rafale fighters to have an availability rate of over 94%. This means that at any point in time, out of the 36 embarked Rafales, 34 are ready to fly. According to the French Navy, a 94% availability rate would make any airwing extremely jealous. For reference, the FA-18 availability rate on the American supercarriers was 43% back in 2014, although by 2023, it had almost doubled to 80%. Another important feature of the Charles de Gaulle is its nuclear-powered propulsion system. In fact, aside from the United States, France is the only nation in possession of a nuclear-powered aircraft carrier. This allows the carrier to continuously steam ahead at 25 knots for about 5 years. In practice, it takes her about 7 to 10 years to burn through its low enrichment fuel called caramel. A big advantage of nuclear power is that it enables this carrier to go from 0 to 20 knots in just 4 minutes and reach her maximum speed of 27 knots in 7 minutes. In contrast, older, conventionally powered carriers can take dozens of minutes to reach their maximum speed. In addition, nuclear reactors take relatively small space, since they don't require smokestacks or designated fuel storage areas. But installing the two nuclear reactors aboard Charles de Gaulle also resulted in some drawbacks. The island on Charles de Gaulle is located in an unfavorable forward location, partially due to her being nuclear-powered. Nuclear reactors on American supercarriers are refueled every 25 years, but this French carrier needs refueling much more frequently, once every 7 to 10 years. The island's suboptimal positioning was to allow easier access to the nuclear reactors. Charles de Gaulle's nuclear reactors are also often criticized for being underpowered. Instead of developing a dedicated nuclear reactor for the aircraft carrier, the French simply took the existing reactor design from the Le Triomphant class submarine and installed it on their new carrier. The intention was to save money, but the French still ended up spending more money to supercharge the K-15 nuclear reactors, so that the carrier could specifically reach a maximum speed of 27 knots. That's because 27 knots is the minimum speed required to safely catapult a fully loaded Rafale fighter in zero true wind. While each of the two K-15 nuclear reactors installed on Charles de Gaulle produce 150 megawatts of power, the two American A-4W reactors installed on Nimitz-class carriers produce 550 megawatts each. The supercarrier's exact top speed is of course classified, but the theoretical maximum is believed to be 44 knots. Interestingly, both retired conventionally powered French aircraft carriers, Foch and Clemenceau, had a maximum speed of 32 knots, which was 5 knots more than the Charles de Gaulle's. Now, it may seem that the nuclear reactors on Charles de Gaulle are what handicapped her top speed. But for many years, it was her propellers. While sailing to Norfolk, Virginia in November 2000, one of the carrier's propellers disintegrated. Specifically, one of the propeller blades just fell off and sank to the bottom of the ocean. This forced the carrier to return to her home port. The interesting thing is that prior to this incident, it was already known that both propellers were defective due to poor manufacturing, but they're installed anyway. When the carrier returned to France to investigate the issue, it came to light that the carrier's two brand new spare propellers were also defective. The strength of the propellers was compromised due to the large amount of bubbles and cracks found inside the copper aluminium alloy near the center of the propellers. Maybe they should have used aluminum instead. This led to a huge scandal, with politicians launching an investigation to find the guilty party. It turned out that the propeller supplier, Atlantic Industries, was responsible for the poor craftsmanship. But mysteriously, a fire destroyed the engineering and design department files at the manufacturing company, hindering a complete understanding of the issue. A fire always makes for a better scandal, doesn't it? With the spare propellers also being defective, it seemed like the poor carrier would be stuck at port for 18 months while new propellers were being made. But the situation was saved when the old propellers from the retiring French aircraft carrier Clemenceau was salvaged and installed on Charles de Gaulle. The only issue was that at higher speeds, the old propellers caused too much vibration, so the speed of the carrier was limited to around 25 knots. It wasn't until May 2008 that the new Made in USA propellers were installed, which allowed the ship to reach her maximum speed of 27 knots. Even though nuclear power allows the ship to travel long distances, in practice, the operational freedom of any nuclear-powered aircraft carrier is limited by the amount of food and aircraft fuel that it can house. Charles de Gaulle carries up to 315 tons of food, 600 tons of munitions, and 3,400 tons of aviation fuel, which gives the carrier 45 days of autonomous operation. She can also carry 1,000 tons of diesel to resupply the escort ships. The fuel reserves on board the ship allow the carrier airwing to conduct about 700 flights in total, meaning that with a top sortie rate of 100 flights per day, the carrier would exhaust its fuel reserves in just 7 days. But historically, Charles de Gaulle has performed 45 sorties per day during high-intensity missions, which means the fuel reserves would last for about 2 weeks. To enable longer deployments, there's always a replenishment tanker assigned to the carrier, which provides an additional 30 days of endurance. With one underway replenishment per week, the carrier's fuel levels on board would never drop below 70%. Plus, during high-intensity scenarios, a second tanker would be assigned to the carrier strike group. So one tanker would always be shuttling supplies between the replenishment ports and the carrier. Even though Charles de Gaulle is arguably the sole most powerful aircraft carrier outside the supercarriers, ironically, being the only one is also her biggest weakness. That's because each time the carrier goes into maintenance, which could last for years, the French Navy loses its aircraft carrier capability altogether. In fact, this is why the Royal Navy decided to build two Queen Elizabeth-class aircraft carriers. So when one is undergoing maintenance, the other one would be available for deployment. That said, according to the rule of thirds, to have one operational aircraft carrier at any point in time, you really need to have at least three aircraft carriers. So how come France didn't at least build two carriers like the Brits did? Back in the 1980s, France had plans to build two nuclear-powered aircraft carriers. But things didn't work out. The construction of Charles de Gaulle began in 1987 and took 14 years to finish. This was due to the government stopping the funding of the carrier on multiple occasions. So when the carrier was eventually commissioned in 2001, Charles de Gaulle was already showing her age. Pipes were corroding and cracks in the hull were starting to appear. And this taught them a valuable lesson. If you're gonna build a ship, just build it. Don't take your sweet croissant time, because it will cost you more at the end. The cost of constructing this carrier was about $2.2 billion, which was roughly half of the $4.3 billion spent on USS Ronald Reagan, the American supercarrier that entered service that same year. As a result of all the delays and being over baguette, which is French for being over budget, in 2005, the French government voted against building a second aircraft carrier, leaving Charles de Gaulle without any sister ships, a decision that would panic them about a decade later. In 2017, Charles de Gaulle entered her midlife refit, which was going to last about 2 years, and this worried the French Navy. Their worry, however, was not about the ship, but about the savoir-faire of the airwing. In English, savoir-faire means expertise. 2 years to go without practicing any flight operations is a long time. Lucky for them, the Americans offered Charles de Gaulle's airwing a tremendous opportunity to train with them on their supercarriers, which was possible since French aircraft could also operate from American supercarriers. As a result, in spring of 2018, the French Navy brought 13 aircraft and 350 personnel to Virginia to conduct flight operations aboard American supercarriers. Speaking of expertise, outside Americans, French naval aviators are currently one of the most experienced in the world, since Charles de Gaulle was employed to Afghanistan in 2001, 2002, 4, 6, 7, and 2010, in Libya in 2011, and in Iraq and Syria in 2015 and 2016. By then, Charles de Gaulle had performed more than 40,000 fighter sorties. In December 2020, the French President Emmanuel Macron announced that Charles de Gaulle was expected to retire in 2038, after which he'd be replaced by the all-new aircraft carrier Porte-Avions Nouvelle Génération, or PANG. With a displacement of 83,000 tons, PANG will be as large as Queen Elizabeth-class aircraft carriers. This carrier would feature all-new K-22 nuclear reactors, electromagnetic catapults, and advanced arresting gear, making PANG the very first supercarrier to be commissioned by the French Navy.